The third chapter of the Westminster Confession begins with these words: God, from all eternity, did, by the most wise and holy counsel of his own will, freely and immutably ordain whatsoever comes to pass. How many of you believe that statement? The Augustinian tradition. Because if you don't believe this statement, you understand that fundamentally, bottom line, you're an atheist. This statement here distinguishes theists from atheists.
Now I know what you're thinking. What just happened? Has he lost his mind? The primary cause for everything that takes place in this world is God himself.
How many of you believe that statement?
He actually tries to argue that your thoughts are only the result of determinism, and he's trying to change my mind by what he perceives to be cogent arguments.
How many of you believe that statement? And you're an atheist.
Have you lost your mind? I can't help what I believe. I can't help that I disagree with you, with everything in my being.
God, from all eternity, did ordain whatsoever comes to pass. Now, does that sound strange? Let me take a breath there. The reality of the existence of God cannot be determined on the basis of what I want to be true. You're an atheist.
Have you lost your mind?
I thought about this question, and I was troubled by it.
That was determined in the decrees of God. I can't help what I believe. I can't help that I disagree with you, with everything in my being. And all we have to do is find a way to recover our minds. Never mind.
It seems to me that I'm facing a contradiction here. I'm thinking, if God is really sovereign and we can't really be free, or if we're really free, God can't really be sovereign.
Have you lost your mind?
It is possible for people to construct philosophical systems on the basis of their own desires, on the basis of their own prejudices and biases, and have that cloud their thinking. I mean, there are many theists, you know, who affirm the existence of God, who deny
God from all eternity did ordain whatsoever.
I radically disagree.
I want to get to the truth. Is there a God or isn't there?
Talking about truth, not preference. Talking about reality.
The truth is that which corresponds to reality as it is perceived by God.
Now, does that sound strange?
No matter. So that this seemingly profound answer to my question sort of fell by its own weight. And what amazes me is how so many people seem to stumble over it.
What's wrong with you people?